Hello everybody and welcome to this tutorial. Today I am going to just continue up on Evil Twin. We have managed to get the client to associate with us, but what good is it? Primarily because that client will not have internet access until we configure our network settings so that there is a bridge between our fake wireless access point and an interface, our network interface, which actually has internet connection. Only then will the client on the other side actually be able to access internet, and only then will we actually be able to harvest any sort of information of whatsoever. So on the right side, for this purpose, I have made a series of commands which you will need to run, and they're not really complicated. It's more or less the same command running over and over again with different interfaces. What you will need first is bridge utils. So go ahead and type in yum. Let me just zoom this in for you. Yum search. And I'm just going to copy paste the name. Excellent. There we go. So it says bridge utils x8664. You need to install this. Hopefully by now you have learned how to install these things. But just in case you didn't, all you need to do is type in yum install and then paste it. By default, it will pick up that it's this package, x8664. Just type in yum install bridge utils space dash y, and that's going to install without asking you any questions. Now, I have it already installed here, so there's no need to go through the process. Next up, what we need to do is have this one. It says bridge add evil. You can name it any way you like. I have named it evil, but it doesn't really matter. Whatever the name will go, this name is completely irrelevant as far as I know, so just go ahead and type in. It says device evil already exists, can't create bridge with the same name. Doesn't matter for me, it already exists because I have previously created. For you, this command will just fly without any sort of problems of whatsoever. Now, the next thing that you need to do, well, this is where it says P8P1. That is the interface. Let me just show you. ifconfig. There's a whole lot of interfaces and information now here. I'm going to need to change the zoom here. Clear. Excellent. This is much better. So, look. The interface P8P1 is the interface that I'm currently using. That is my wired interface, and that interface has internet access. What I need to do is bridge evil and P8P1, and that is exactly what this command will do for us. So just go ahead and copy. There we go. Okay, P8P1 is already a member of bridge, can't enslave it to the bridge evil. So I've already added it, so it can't repeat the process twice. For you, again, the command will fly. Now, we have linked this intermediary evil interface, interface named evil, to the interface P8P1, which actually has internet connectivity. However, we also need to add to this the interface which is created by Airbase, and that is AT0. Basically, what we're doing is repeating the process twice. Let's just go ahead and clear the screen. Paste. So you see, previously I have added P8P1, which has internet connectivity, to evil. I have bridged them, and now I'm going to bridge AT0 to evil. Don't worry, AT0 should be the same on your system because Airbase will create this interface for you. No problems there. All you need to do is bridge it to this intermediary, and you should eventually have internet connectivity. Press enter. Again, I get an error message because it says that the process has already taken place and it cannot duplicate it. For you, it's going to fly. Next up, basically, what we need to do is add IP addresses to these interfaces, and furthermore, we need to change their state to up, primarily because the states of these interfaces are not up by default, and that can be a problem. So you just need to bring it up manually. No big deal. These commands are pretty simple and straightforward. So ifconfig, which we've used before, name of the interface. This is the, strange as it might look, this actually is the IP address, and just say up. Excellent. There we go. Confirmation. No confirmation message. No, nothing. The command has passed through. Excellent. Now we need to bring evil up as well. So our bridging interface, ifconfig evil up, no need to assign an IP address there. And we don't need to bring P8P1, of course, up, primarily because it's already up, it has internet connectivity. Just copy this as well, paste, so dh client 3 evil ampersand sign, press enter, yep, there we go. Hold on, wait, why are you giving me this? Let's remove the redirection. Excellent, there we go. So you can just type in DHC client evil and that should work as well. I'm fairly certain that this command has worked a moment ago, but doesn't really matter. It says DH client is already running existing, so no need to actually do anything here for me, but for you, you will just need to go and follow through pretty much exactly what I've said. Now, once this is configured, you see that my airbase on this side is still running. So I have not shut it down since last time I did this. Now the client on the other side, either the phone or a tablet or a computer or something of a kind that is connecting to our fake access point, to our evil twin, will have internet connectivity, will be able to browse the net, and will literally suspect nothing. Because, you know, you get disconnected from wireless. It's not uncommon. I mean, be honest with yourselves. Ask yourselves, if I get disconnected from a wireless for a couple of seconds, will I suspect that there's some foul play here, that somebody's doing something or that somebody's hacking or something of a kind? No, of course not. If you get deauthenticated, you will simply press reconnect, or the device will reconnect automatically for you, and while you're waiting for that reconnect, you'll probably be staring at the device, literally looking at it, and not suspecting a thing. Anyway, in the follow-up tutorial, I am going to show you how you can actually monitor the traffic of somebody that is connected to your fake wireless access point, and how you can extract that information. Until then, I bid you farewell, and hope to see you in the next tutorial.